guy has truly made the takedown a thing of beauty in mixed martial arts. With respect to yourself and George St. Pierre and the truly great takedown artists, this guy's closing the gap and entering that company in the eyes of many.
Oh, absolutely, because he's done such a great job of timing takedowns. I haven't seen anyone so good at slipping a jab into a takedown since George St. Pierre.
Right.
He does a phenomenal job of getting step one and step two before his opponent even realizes now he's in on my leg. And if they do get their hip back, immediately he's up into a foot sweep or a headlock or an inside trip. It's just so many different ways for him to get you to the floor that he will throw every single one at you every single time.
And a lot of fighters talk about that wrestling maintenance and how hard it is, right, over the course of a career to continue to drill those things. He talks a lot about that, and that's why he's continued to realize success here in the UFC. Well, always exciting when this guy shows up on the fight card, Daniel. He is a true mixed martial artist. Not really any glaring weaknesses, at least, that he's put on film thus far.
He's the new breed of fighter. Those kids that start doing everything at 6 years old. They start wrestling, they start doing jiu-jitsu, they start to box. He's one of those guys that has every one of those skills, and he does them all at an A-plus level. He's got tremendous cardio. He is the type of fighter that in a few years will just litter the UFC roster across the board.
And oftentimes his opponents will say he doesn't really do anything special, but he does everything at a plus level, and he believes he'll have a... So here we go with the start of this fight. I'm anxious, man. What a matchup it is, and it's going to be interesting. And it's going to be interesting to see who has the upper hand early.
It's going to be difficult to find out how this plays out, right? Striker versus well-rounded fighter. Who's going to be the one that's going to control where this fight takes place?
Oh, really using his reach advantage there with that punch, DC. Oh, that couldn't have felt good as he lands the knee to the body. He's a tall fighter, and he's going to have the size advantage against most opposition in this division. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
Try to establish that jab.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Oh, that right hand is on point. All right, so there's the early takedown. He told us on Thursday he didn't necessarily see a path to victory. If he couldn't get takedowns, that is certainly a good sign.
Right away, he got the takedown. I don't believe they could have imagined that it would work so well so early. Great job.
Oh, nice job here staying busy off of his back. Nice offense from the boss. And he is back up to his feet.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Effective punch there by the Korean Super Bowl. Oh, caught him flush with the head kick there, DC.
Beautiful setup to get his leg up there quickly before his opponent could react.
Man, he's timing his shots nicely. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed the target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop it. John, stop it.
Well, he misses with the left punch there. Oh, a little single collar tie there.
And this dude's cashing chips. Fantastic timing.
All right, working inside the now open guard of his opponent. Uh-oh.
Throwing up a triangle. The guy on his back is very good at submissions, and if he's not careful here, he's going to get stuck, and he will have to submit.
Throwing that jab, no good. Nice connection with a punch there. It's hard to recall a time in the past that his boxing looked this sharp.
He's never looked this good.
Well, a lot of people think he might have the best jab in this division, certainly using it effectively here.
I mean, one of the best jabs in the world across all combat sports. The way that it just comes out, it's beautiful. The backside hand is always at the chin. The elbows tucked to the ribs. The jab goes out. The jab comes right back to the face. It's picture-perfect technique, almost like a Taibo class or something like that.
Let's go. Set up that takedown.
Ooh, what a punch.
Some nice back-and-forth action here.
Very tricky when he throws that body kick.
Well, he's been good tonight, but he missed with that one. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
He loaded up with that right there, too.
Saul really exploiting his reach advantage as he landed the jab there, DC. And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands. Mercier gets hit by that leg kick. You may want to start checking some of these. Unable to land with that punch.
Right under the elbow, the body kick lands. Liver kick, if you take those kicks, it's going to shut your body off.
Oh, he found the target there. That'll work. Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue. All right, so the taller fighter.
He hurt him.
Offensive fight. Nice job to block the shot there. Well, that one should leave a mark. Outstanding leg kick employed there by Choi. All right, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie. Oh, and there he goes again, working off that beautiful jab. He continues to keep his opponent at distance.
I mean, keeps him at bay with that beautiful, precise jab. It is like a piston. It goes in and out, and before his opponent can even realize what hit him, he's already hitting him with another one.
Right.
I love watching this man fight because of that beautiful, educated jab.
All right, close guard now. Oh, and he's able to land a strike there from the bottom. Nicely done by Choi. Minutes in the books.
Hey, stop.
All right, no telestrator for DC tonight, but we'll get you some replays. And if you like face punching, that was a good round.
Yeah, where's my telestrator, man? I want to draw this action. But yeah, John, you're right. It was the striking. It was the punches that really did allow him to take control of this round.
He talked a lot to us about his length and his size advantage. Doesn't always pay to be the taller fighter. In this instance, it certainly did. Double jab landed there by the Korean Super Bowl. Wow.
Big powerful punch land. Now he gets back in range.
DC, didn't take him long to find his range here tonight, huh?
His timing is on point.
All right, so he lands another jab now, just snapping that thing off, DC.
I believe that the jab was lost in mixed martial arts initially. But now it has been found, and it's been found by this young man in this octagon tonight.
And they separate. Again, he's looking for that left. It's not there. That shot is blocked by Aubin Mercier.
Over and over, he lands a big body kick. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
And both guys really throwing with authority. Aubin Mercier's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. Oh, continuing to work the body to great effect.
That right hand hurt him a little bit.
Swing and a miss by Aubin Mercier. All right, he engages in a single collar tie here.
Real quick leg kick.
Well, no surprise, he goes for the takedown there, unable to get the fight to the canvas.
This is a testament to his opponent, his ability to see the shots coming, defend them, and make the fight happen where he wants to. Oh, big punch lands.
All right, so there he goes, continuing to land that jab. When they put this highlight together, it's just gonna be one head snapping back.
It's gonna be boxers going back and watching this guy going, wow, this is what a jab is supposed to look like.
Nice 1-2 there. Single collar tie now.
great punch.
Quick level change now.
He went single into a high crotch. Oh, he's taking his neutral right. Oh, my God. He switched the lock to a high crotch, rotated him, and took him for a ride. That was a big takedown.
Just over 2 minutes to go in the round. While working pretty effectively from the top here, nice ground and pound by Aubame Mercier.
Use your hits to hit
up. Oh, man. This ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is his opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land these beautiful ground and pound combinations.
All right, so he continues to land that jab. His opponent said he was ready for it, but doesn't appear to be.
You're not ready until you're in there. You can watch all the film you want. You can spar as much as you want, but until you feel a guy with a fast jab like this, you don't understand the precision of that punch.
Nice knee to the midsection there.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots.
Straight punch lands. Look at him working at trying to shut the liver down.
So a much different approach for him here in the second round. He was a little bit tentative in round one, a little bit of the feeling out process. Now he has clearly found his rhythm, found the range. We'll see if he can continue with more activity here in round two. Aubame Mercier gets touched by that leg kick attempt.
Good punch lands.
Back and forth we go. He comes forward with a flying knee that just missed hitting the target flush. Rip the body there. 15 seconds remain in the round. So he lands a double jab there. He continues to work off of that weapon, and you felt like that was a big key for him coming into.
Very important for him to start popping that jab over and over again, and he's finding a ton of success.
All right, that's the end of round number two.
All right, recover, shake it off. That round doesn't matter. We're gonna move forward this round and really put the pressure on this guy. Let's take him out of his element.
All right, so a lot of highlights over those previous 5 minutes. DC, take us through the replay, if you will.
A lot of good action, but punching led the dance. Punching was the thing that stood out to me. That allowed him to take control of the round.
You ready? You ready?
Third round underway. It's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Aubame Mercier. Well, most fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight.
Punch over the top.
Well, he's got the longer reach, and he certainly showed it there in landing that straight punch. Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Just misses there with the left.
Big kick.
Just misses with the right. Nice punch there by Choi. Just out of range with that left hook. All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually you're gonna have to put something on your opponent that's gonna really make him pause. I believe the jab has been working so well, if he drops a big right hand after it, he may be able to finish his fight.
All right, single collar tie now. All right, so again, the fighters clinch here. Kind of had an inkling we'd find ourselves back in this situation.
Absolutely. Both of these fighters love fighting chest to chest. The uglier the fight, the better.
Nice kick landed there by Aubame Mercier. Just over 3 minutes to go now. Glancing right hand lands upstairs. Well, the right hand has been there at times, not that time. Well, it's all pace and pressure down the stretch. He is really lighting him up now. Very nice leg kick there by Aubin Mercier.
Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body with that body kick.
Oh, nice.
And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if there's more where that came from.
Boxing, boxing, boxing. You done over and over. You come up, you go down. Another takedown land.
Aubin Mercier's lower jaw very swollen now. Time to bite down on the mouthpiece and move forward. All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Oh, nice job to reverse position on the ground.
It was bad, but now it's not so bad. What a fantastic sweep.
All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent, you gotta be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Close guard. Both fighters get up now. Oh, shot to the body connects there. He hasn't really thrown too many body strikes in this fight, but now, as this fight goes on, he is not discriminating, working the body, and those shots are gonna count. Oh, and he connects there. Pretty nice punch there.
Great job finding the range to land those punches.
Oh, and the Superman punch is good. Punch coming, it's blocked. Oh, huge right hand.
News hurt, serve him up.
Both guys landing at a pretty decent clip. Oh, big knee! Oh!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, you gotta like the output here. So aggressive with the strikes, he continues to light him up. Gotta be careful here not to gas out, of course, but you gotta like the offense we're seeing from him, especially in this round. Well, that body kick was there earlier, not there on that attempt. Oh, beautiful straight right hand. Trying to establish that jab once again. Oh, and he connects there. His hands look good to me.
So fast. I mean, this guy has tremendous hand speed.
All right, we now take a look back at some of the highlights from that last round, DC. A lot for the replay guys to choose from.
I mean, these guys are going to be very busy trying to find what replay to show you guys. Lands on both sides of the octagon. Both guys fought great. What a phenomenal round.
Had him hurt, almost finished. Look at him on the stool. He's still wobbling. This round, to put the pressure on, get right in his face.
All right, so next round underway here, and you gotta admire the stamina that both of these guys still exuded towards the end of that round. Both men put a particular focus on their cardiovascular commitment in this training camp, and it's clearly paid dividends here tonight. We have two legitimately fresh fighters here as we hit this next round. Punches in bunches, and he hasn't really shown any signs of slowing down here tonight. I'm not sure how much more his opponent can take. Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down there.
Oh!
He's in trouble. He's getting lit
throwing
up.
Throwing haymakers out of the exchange.
To throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish his fight. You don't know when that leg kick's coming.
All right, he engages in the single collar tie. Big knee to the body. Nice punch there by Choi.
Big body kick lands.
Well, he's looking for that left hand, just out of range though with it. All right, so a high amplitude double leg takedown there. Now we'll see what he can do with it to try to advance position on the ground.
You knew that he was gonna attack the double because he's such an explosive guy. He got it on the hips, finished the shot very quickly. Fantastic job.
All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
All right, we'll see how he chooses to defend here. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Bob Mercier gets back up, back into his comfort zone. Whoa! Well, he's got his back now. All right, half guard form here, and a lot of offensive options, I would think, at his disposal.
Oh, he's got a ton of options. He has submission options, but I believe the safest option for him here is going to be to use his ground and pound. Build a base, posture up, throw big strikes, get back in position, build posture again, throw big strikes, and just really wear him down.
Oh!
Look at that. He's in trouble. It's over. It's over. He got him. What a performance.
Just the way he drew it up as he gets the knockout victory here tonight, it's hard to land a strike more flush than he did right there, and I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming, so they'll see the replay and probably shake his head, but ultimately this is a huge result and a huge win for that fighter here tonight. Well, hard to perform much better than he did tonight. A huge knockout under the lights. They'll be talking about that one for some time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Ian Levine has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 31 seconds of round number 4. Declaring the winner by